I'm finally checked into my hotel room. It's Wednesday, so still got quite a bit of time before the actual con starts. Don't really have much to do right now other than just waiting for my roommates to arrive. Let's take a look around.
While we're here, I've got to fit in at least one stereotypical tourist attraction. You know, I wonder how many times somebody's dropped their phone through one of these gaps. I mean, it's got to have happened at least once. Alright, it is about 5:45, just got back to the hotel and we've got people here. Thankfully I didn't actually miss registration today.
Everfree, use of cardboard, like takeaway boxes, or I'm not sure. It honestly looks like the packing of some kind of electronics going on.
Yeah, kind of.
But that's the whole thing.
A cup holster here. Huh? A cup holster.
Cup holster. Oh, I like that cup holster.
Have they made belts with built-in cup holders? Why is that not a thing? Is it? It should be.
Three,
two, one.
Stop putting pieces on.
Tools down. Round of applause for both teams. So what we're gonna do, let's have both of our models from each team step forward here through the gap.
We need to walk in front of the tables.
So what we're gonna do, just stand right here for me. All right, so why don't we start over here. Tell us who you are.
Hi, my name's Liv. My character? I'm the Sheriff Liv. Yeah.
Very nice. I like it. Very nice use of the foil here for the sheriff star. The netting is included. Very nice. I think my favorite aspect of this is the hat. The flowers are a good touch there. And how about over here? Who are you?
Sheriff Hunter.
Oh, battle of the sheriffs.
Something else?
No, you're good. It's looking good. So we got netting here as the sort of the poncho as well. I think my favorite aspect of this one has got to be the chaps, however. Very nice use of those right there. And tied around the legs at the bottom, too. Okay. All right. We're both looking great. So we're going to do the audience clap-o-meter to determine a winner. So clap really loud if you want that team to win. So how about over here? All right. Need to do that again, so really communicate that this time. Be nice and loud when you have that team that you want to win. How about over here? Good. Over here.
All right, sounds like Team Wolf to me.
I think so. I think we have our winner. Congratulations. Forgot to mention at the beginning. First of all, round of applause for both of our teams here for participating.
Yes, thank you. We literally can't do this show.
And we do have prizes as well.
Do you grab it?
I'm going to go grab it right now.
All right, you guys are welcome to keep your costumes. You're welcome to chuck them in the bin. Just a nice background.
This is lovely.
I see it now. I love it.
Just under 7 minutes left. 7 minutes left in this round.
7 minutes left.
I think both of these teams are looking like they're making very good use of time here.
Yes,
they're going to have a lot of leisure time at the end to add fine details, which is great.
Whenever you get the broad strokes done, always remember, you can add more detail onto it. You can add, some contrast. You can add some texture, some something. The broad strokes are there. You've done great. You've gotten there already. Just, put a little extra love in it. You know, that thing that a lot of people do with their cosplays of like, but I didn't get that detail right. Like, did you get the broad strokes?
Yeah.
And the rest is great. The rest is just like, what makes it shine? Everybody knows what you already are. Make it pretty. There we go.
This is great.
I'm loving this.
This is some excellent cosplay action happening right now.
Oh, I didn't know that there was a second part to the flower cardigan thing.
This is where the trade-off for assembling everything on the table ahead of time really shows here in the final moments as we reach the end of this round, because we now only have 60 seconds remaining on the clock. 60 seconds. 60 seconds left to add any final details to the costume. Any last items, it must be attached in order to count.
A pine cone,
a good finishing touch. I like it. I don't know where those came from, but I'm just glad they somehow made it in here. This is the Northwest. We have these. 30 seconds.
We have pine trees, right?
That's looking pretty good.
Thank you.
Well, that was a pretty nice dinner. Had some pretty good conversations. But now, it's time to head down to the third floor. Okay, so as it turns out, I think it might be in the other tower.
You're aware of a store that used to be called Toys R Us, right?
Yes.
You have been in such a store.
Yes, that's my child.
Exactly.
Exactly. Boys.
So, this is what it's like.
I'll be honest, this copy is way more convenient than the one in the con book. Okay, it took me a minute, but I think that says best con. I mean, okay. And of course, Vancouver had to do this. And then Harmony Con is just like, eh, whatever. Actually, I'm not entirely sure if this is supposed to be something. Like, if you kind of look at it from this angle, it kind of looks like a musical note. I'm not sure what to make of this one.
Yeah.
In case you didn't notice, it's a very cumbersome costume. It's very difficult to move around in, so I give them kudos.
Thank you.
division. Our winner is Stephanie. Stephanie is Princess Luna. I think it was Nightmare Moon. My apologies, Nightmare Moon.
Everything about that cosplay, so I was just like blown away. So come on up, Jacqueline.
our job by spring gets harder every single year because the new cosplayers every time up their game. There are people who have come in first year and made costumes, and I'm always so impressed with them. So I really appreciate you guys for coming, and I appreciate our cosplayers for the hard work. Good job, thank you.
Thank you. Just about every, like, known Brony musician is probably in that server at this point. And so if you have a question about any genre, there's someone there who can help you.
Also, one point I'd like to make, Luck Rock, I think Drake Emberhart and many other people, they do this website called Horse Music Herald. A lot of great stuff, a lot of new music. If you guys want to check out new Brony music, go to horsemusicherald.com. They got everything.
For the modern Brony music panel tomorrow, we're going to talk all about that. All right, last well, question. I know things were a little hard last year, so I was wondering, how were you able to overcome everything that went on with the pandemic? How were you able to cope with that?
Question.
I'm not usually excited to answer that, is that okay?
Go for it.
The wonderful thing that I learned last year was that it's easier than people expect to just do your own thing. If you want to perform at a show, you can literally just get a Twitch channel, learn how to set that up, and be like, hey, I'm about to perform a set. I'm about to spin, you know, I'm going to DJ for an hour. So I started doing more DJ sets, and a lot of online shows started, like, having me on board as well, which is great. But even without those, just, like, I learned to just take more control of what I had and do more with that. Yeah, just, like, starting things, like, yeah, you can just put on your own show.
I guess I'll add to that, like what Odyssey said, when the pandemic started, I just started out on like Renegade Stage, helping out. It was just starting with Ponyfest, and I just like said, hey, let me help host Renegade Stage, and that kind of worked out. Then I started working on drumming other performances, learning how to do, you know, presets or whatever, and working my way up through like better quality production. As time went on, and I've told this to many musicians, but just starting out small and then working your way up, working as hard as you can to get where you are, and basically just work as hard as you can and you'll finally get a spot.
This is a good opportunity to learn new things.
Absolutely.
To adapt to the situation.
Absolutely.
Anyone else have anything they want to say about that?
Like this has definitely helped with me, at least in the past year and a half, maintaining the friendship circles that you have, knowing that they're there to support you and help you through any orders and through any hard times. Like me personally, I've had my circle of friends and of course my wife to help me. But also try to keep yourself occupied by, you know, letting your creative juices flow to think like, okay, so you know, I'm stuck here for a bit. What can I possibly do to keep myself occupied, not think about the world around me? And I spent that time to think like, okay, who could I reach out to possibly, you know, create new stuff with, new songs, new covers, and the like. You know, just something to keep your creative energy flowing. And that's how I've actually come up with some new mashup ideas that I'm actually going to be premiering today.
Ooh,
good luck.
I think I might show the other side of that coin. I actually think it was a little hard over, you know, everything that happened in the past 2 years. It started out great, and personally, I got a lot of work done, got some bunch of new music, but after a while, you know, I didn't have any cons to share music with people, or not a lot of human interaction, and it kind of made it hard after a while to have that motivation, so.
Yeah, so like, sometimes you can work for others, and they cannot just do whatever you feel works best for you in the moment.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's more of a generalization of like.
So what you're saying is make sense tonight?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you for that.
Yeah.
Thank you. Avenge the Kiki Empire.
Yeah. Kiki Empire.
Yeah.
fairy tales.
Are you back?
Just having some dinner at the park. It's like 10:20 right now, and I think I might be missing some stuff, but actually I just saw a tweet from the con saying that a fire alarm was activated and they had to evacuate for a bit. So I guess I'm not missing much. It is 10:33 and I think so we got fire trucks here, so I guess that evacuation is still in place. Or maybe not. I guess I got the tail end of that.
Okay.
Or knights. Humorous badge ribbon acquired. I was gonna get one of these. I mean, then again, I don't really have a pony OC. Barely do, and I also vaguely have a fursona. That's about it. Okay, got a con shirt. Close enough.
You should.
The modern Brony music panel is ending like right now, so I mean, I gotta get out, get some lunch before the charity auction, so. Well, I thought it'd be a little quicker than that. The charity auction's technically already started, I think. It's a few minutes after 2:30, but anyway, I gotta rant a little bit about my relationship with the Brony music scene. See, I feel like I've been out of touch with it for several years now, and both in terms of discovery and creation. And I think in terms of discovery, at least, I think the reason why I'm kind of out of touch with it is just I have very specific musical tastes. That's nobody's fault but my own. But you know what I'm going to do? I might just create like a top 5 songs, or maybe 5, 10. I feel like I would only get 5 songs that I've discovered in the past 2 years, 2020 and 2021. Ideally, they would have been created during that time frame, but maybe not. Just to kind of illustrate my taste, just kind of, you know, support what I love rather than attacking what I don't.
So, what have you got for us here?
Well, we came all the way from the Sweet Apple Acres here, and we brought you some of Granny Smith's very own Zap Apple Jam! There are three pint jars in here. It is vegan, it is gluten-free, and it is all natural, and it is canned. It will last you for up to a year before you open it. And some of y'all have gotten to taste it. Who's tasting it? How was it?
Great.
Testimony there.
So authentic Zap Apple Jam that has an endorsement from the crowd that it is great, it is gluten-free, it is vegan, it will last you a year, it is shelf-stable, it is beautiful, and you get three whole jars of it. Dusty, where shall we start this off?
Oh, I like Zap Apple Jam. How we start that off at like $40?
Absolutely, that's $40. $40, ooh, yeah.
Wait a minute, that was Flim or Flam?
Who let
that
in?
Flam. Flam is trying to get the recipe to this jam. To copy it. Oh, I'd like a 200. 250. Ow. 250 for jam. Oh, and he's in. Okay, here we go. We got two players. 275. Three. Three quarter. 350. 375. Four. Four quarter. 450. 475. Five. $500 for jam.
Let's give him some encouragement, folks, because we got the first bidding word.
Five and a quarter going once, five and a quarter going twice. 535. So!
Let everybody know it's a jam and you have pretended to be a fabulous recipe for all the Flintman brothers. So well done. 550. Six. Out at 550, in at 550. Anyone else in at 550? Because I like that number. 550 going once. 550 going twice. Congratulations, 550 sold for these two wonderful reps!
Once. Three. 75 going twice. Sold. $375. Use them to wreak havoc on your games. Four. Four going once, four going twice. Sold, $400, that gentleman right there. He was in college. Signed by Sonny Westbrook, because friendship is power. Yes. Oh yes. How about $100 for the original Sonny Westbrook signed with a 1, 2, 3, I like it. Are you in? Keep it way up, you're way back, I gotta see you. Awesome, thank you very much. One and a quarter, 150, 175, two.
Yeah.
Two. Anybody else? Two going once, two going twice. Oh, I'm sorry, thank you very much. Two and a quarter. 250. 275. Three. Out. Three. Going once, three. Going twice. Sold, $300. Yeah. 450. 450. 450 going once. 450 going twice. Sold, $450. So this is all different Brony t-shirts over the years. A lot of them are Everfree Northwest. Some of them are, of course, We Love Fine, plus all of the beautiful pony fabric on the back side. Let's show the back real quick. It's all one color. Split. It's a beautiful, I don't even want to know how many hours we're into making this thing. Oh my God.
It is delightfully soft. You can curl up in this and sleep for
this
days.
This thing is take a nap all day long. All day long. I'll never get out of bed. Never get out of bed. Just gonna mold. But there you go. How about, I'm not even gonna go short on this one. This one's gonna be five bills. $500. So I got one up there. You in five? Hand way up. Thank you very much. Five over here. All right, $500. Huh?
Make it $1,000.
$1,000. Good choice. $1,000 going once. $1,000 going twice. So. Goes home with you. Hands. 220. 240. 260. 280. 3. 320. 340. 360. 380. 4. 420. 440. You're out. You're out. 440. You're in. 460. 480. 5. 520. 540. 560. 580. 6. You're both pretty strong. How we go 650? How we go 7? 7. 7. 7 going once. 7. Ooh, he's back. 750. Ooh, he was thinking about it. 8. 850. 9. Now he's out. You sure? 9 1/4? No. 9. 9 going once, 9 going twice. So that which you may now turn around. Whoa. But wait, there's more wickets. Now how much would you pay? A second board. Which you may now turn around. But wait, there's more. There is a third and final board. Which please turn around. Look at all of that. Is the gentleman who donated this in the audience? Whereabouts? Please, a huge round of applause. So here's the story with this. It took us three people to count these, and we all got different numbers. So it's about 519 pins there, collected over 5 years. Some of these have gone around the world. The very first one is a derpy. I'm not sure which board it's on, but you have ones from a good half dozen to a dozen different artists. So if you scrubs is on there, there are a couple up there from Pin Philly.
And me. Actually mine right now.
Dusty's are up on there. And even better, if you want to be able to get these back to your house after you win them, the donator has very generously said that he will help out with bins and bubble wrap if you need to put them on a plane. So, we do actually have a few more to add to it, though. Oh, because we have a couple of late additions.
Ooh, that's cool. I don't even have that one.
From AJ and Rules, we have a pin from Gleamy Dreams and a pin from Sophie Scruggs, which I will show to the camera as soon as I'm done bagging them.
Pair of Rainbow Dashes right there, EQG, and of course, wow, that is like that out. Those are cool.
And then we have the Everfree Northwest 2018 pin to add to all the other con pins that are on there. And believe you me, there are many, many other con pins on there. So, while I put this on the board,
in the name of lightning, I will punish you. That's the only line I know from that joke, but anyway.
Now again, the running thing is that I can't do maths, but even I can tell you that a good 500 pins at even $5 a piece is
a lot of money. Lot.
At $10 a piece, which is probably closer to what was paid for it,
it's a lot of money.
A lot.
And everybody knows how much that big heart one over there went for. A lot of money.
So, I've discussed this with certain people, and if this set does not go for a certain number that's in my head, I ain't selling it. Okay? Because that would be akin to thievery if it doesn't go for a certain number. Okay, I got that certain number in my head. I'm not telling you. And what's more, there's a certain number in my head. If it goes above that, I am willing to throw in a few pins from my private collection as well that are not on that board. And I'll talk about them if we hit that number. So,
how about we start at a very round $800. $800 to start. That's still low. At $15 a pin, that's way more than that. $800. Here we go. $850. $9. $950. A grand. One. Oh, let's make it $1,100. $1,200. $1,300. $1,400. $1,500. $1,500. Right there. Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you very much. I didn't.
Sorry about that.
Sorry about that. Thank you for standing up. You and you. 16. 17. 18. 19. $2,000. $2,200. $2,400. $2,600. That was his number.
$2,600. Are you sure about that? Because I will sweeten the deal. Hold that thought, Dusty.
Holding the thought. $2,600. By the way, it's above the number I had in my head. What I would pay for it. Because if it wasn't over that, I was buying it. But it's above that number.
Now, remember, folks, when I mentioned a certain creator named Pinfilly? They are now Darkly Dragon, they're the chair of TrotCon. But back in 2011, 2012, they made some pins. And as a result of making these pins, which proved very popular, they were one of the very first artists and vendors in the fandom to receive a cease and desist order from Hasbro.
That is
so
true.
These are rare, and you can't get them anywhere else. And the winner of this, if it goes above 2,000, makes shoes, whichever of these they like.
Oh. Yep. So all of those, they were so good, they were so early in the fandom, Hasbro said nope.
Also, there is a Luna. It's still on my jacket from wearing it last night, but the Luna is in the mix as well.
Ooh, Luna's in the mix. So you get one of those for winning this. So you want back in? He wants back in. I like it. Black Griffin, Claire Corlette, Sunny Westbrook, Tara Strong, and Kathy Westlock.
So the great and the good of the Pony and official show music community, plus voice actors, plus it's an exclusive from 2013. Folks, we're inching closer to 30,000, so let's start this off at $100. I want to see some hands.
Take it, Foley.
200. 300, lovely. What about 400? 500? 600? 700, we've got two in, out at 700, you're out as well. What about 600 then? You were both in at 600. No, you don't want 600. You were in at 600? Not so sure. All right, fine. What about 550? Can you do 550? 550 in there, all right, then 560, because it's between two. What about 570? 580? You're wavering. What about 590? And we're back to 600 again. You're out at 600, but you're in at 600. You're happy to pay 600 for that. 600 going once. Any other hands that I'm missing? 600 going twice? 600 sold, thank you very much.
$176 of you. Thank you.
back, tasting that thing, will be there to hear everything we have to say. Thank you.
Well, the con is over now, and how's this for meta? I've actually been editing this vlog during the convention. It's about 12:30 now on technically day 4 post-con, and well, this whole thing has just been surreal. Like, I'm not even sure that it actually happened. It's like how when something just rushes past you and you just have to stop for a moment and say, wait, what was that? It's kind of how I feel about this whole convention. Like, you know, since we've been without conventions for over a year now, for the most part, I guess I just wasn't quite prepared to come back. But I'm glad I did.